Well, hello, all you Newport Harbor fans. What we're doing is taking a trip around the harbor, and we're going to talk about the golden age of Newport Beach, the 40s and the 50s and the 60s. You see all these cliffs? They call that the Castaways Development, named after the Castaways Club. These cliffs right here we're using in the movie, The White Cliffs of Dover. It was a love story, one of the greatest love stories ever filmed. And these were supposedly, after World War I, they went back to London, and these were filmed as the White Cliffs of Dover. And up on the top of the cliff was the Castaways. That's where all the movie stars went. There's a little tiny road that goes up there to get up there. Well, you can imagine at 2 o'clock in the morning, when Bogart and all these guys had a few too many drinks, going down that little tiny road down to Dover and down to Coast Highway, it got pretty hairy. And luckily, they knew the chief of police really well. His name was Johnny Upson, who was one of their drinking buddies.
Never thought that you would be standing here so close to me. There's so much I feel that I should say.
Linda Isle was called Shark Island. We used to take our snowbirds, their 12-foot sailboats, we used to sail from Lido over to Shark Island. There was no bridge, it was a desert island. And we used to camp out and tell stories, ghost stories, and we used to go snipe hunting. It was just one big flat island, and there were sand sharks all the way around it. That's why they named it that. This development is called Bay Shores, and we're coming to the beach. It's always marked by the three sagging palm trees. You can't miss it from almost anywhere. And here's the beach. This is where we had our little party barbecue. And right where we are right now, where the boat is where the Swift was moored. Nicolas Cage's house is right here. Before that, it was William Cagney's house. We're going around the corner now. We're approaching John Wayne's house. John Wayne lived in a one-story house, a neat house. Actually, this is his only house that he owned, was this one, and he bought it from Elgin Gates. Elgin Gates was the big game hunter of the world. He was noted as the great white hunter. He was a real great white hunter. Elgin Gates owned Mercury, Evinrude, and Johnson Outboard Motors. He retired when he was 39 years old. And if you ever saw the film Hatari, filmed in Africa with red buttons, John Wayne obviously was a star, where it shows him lassoing a rhinoceros. Elgin Gates was a technical director of that film. And right beyond there, you're gonna see a white house right here in the corner. This is the house on Lido that everybody knows. This house right here was owned by a guy named Ernie Saftick. When Ernie Saftick was gone, guess who stayed at his house? John Wayne.